Due date June 12th. Number of days from 1st April to the date of maturity April 30, May 31, 61 plus 12, 73. Amount of the bill 1,20,000 and rate of discount 7.5%. Hence our calculation is like this: 1,20,000 into 73 divided by 365 into rate of discount divided by 100. And third, due date June 9th. July 9th and amount of the bill 1 lakh. The number of days from 1st April to July 9th, including grace days, April 30, May 31, 61, June 30, 91, and July 9th, 100. July 9th, 100. Days. 1st April to July 9th. 100 days. 3091 plus 9. 100 days. So rate of discount 8.25%. Calculation is like this: 1 lakh into 100 divided by 365 into 8.25 divided by 100. Hence, we can calculate the total amount of rebate on bills discounted. Next problem. From the following particulars, prepare profit and loss account of the established bank for the year ended 31st March 2008. Interest on loans 2,59,000. Interest on loan 2,59,000, that is income that should be shown under schedule number 13, right? Interest on loans, income to the bank. So schedule number 13, interest earned. So there you should show the interest on loans. Next, interest on fixed deposits, that is 2,40,000. So the bank should give the interest on fixed deposits, that is interest expended, not interest earned. Rebate on bills discounted, rupees 49,000. Rebate on bills discounted means rebate for the unexpired period, which is not earned. Received but not yet earned. Commission charged to customers 8,200, that is income. Commission charged to customers. Establishment rupees 54,000. That is establishment expenses or payment of salaries, that is operating expenses. Next, discount on bills discounted 1,95,000. Total amount of discounted bills 1,95,000. And interest on cash credits rupees 2,23,000. That is again income or interest earned. Interest on current accounts, interest expended, schedule number 15. And rent and taxes, that is operating expenses, schedule number 16. Then interest on overdrafts, rupees 54,000. Again, that is income, interest on overdrafts, schedule number 13. Directors and auditors fees, rupees 4,800, operating expenses. Interest on savings bank deposit, rupees 68,000. That is interest expended, schedule number 15. Postage and telegrams, 1,400, operating expenses, schedule number 16. Printing and advertisement rupees 2,900, again that is schedule number 16, operating expenses. Sundry charges 1,700, that is also operating expenses. Interest on non-performing assets is as follows: term loans earned 59,000, collected 40,000. Term loans earned 59,000, collected 40,000. Hence 19,000 is not collected, so that should be deducted from the interest. On term loans, interest on term loans given in the problem 2,59,000. 2,59,000 interest on term loans less 19,000. So the total amount of interest received rupees 2,40,000. Next, interest on cash credits. Interest on cash credits 2,23,000 interest on cash credits less cash credits earned 83,000. Earned 83,000 and collected 65,000. Collected 65,000. Again, there is a difference of 18,000. 18,000. So 2,05,000 interest on cash credits. Next, interest on overdrafts. Interest on overdrafts rupees 54,000 and earned 24,000. Interest on overdrafts earned 24,000 and collected 18,000. Hence the difference is 6,000. Total interest on overdrafts collected how much? Rupees 48,000. Hence the total interest 2,40,000. 2,40,000 and 2,05,000. Next 48,000. 4,93,000. Next discount on bills discounted 1,95,000. 1,95,000. Discount on bills discounted 1,95,000. 6,88,000. 6,88,000. Out of these, you should deduct rebate on bills discounted given in the problem 49,000. So the balance sheet figure 6,39,000. So this should be shown under schedule number 13. Interest earned 6,39,000. Okay. And if you write the schedule number 13, that is interest earned. Schedule number 13, interest earned. There you should mention interest on term loans, interest on cash credits, interest on overdrafts, interest on term loans 2,59,000 minus 19,000, hence 2,40,000. Interest on cash credits 2,23,000 minus 18,000, so 2,05,000. Interest on overdraft 54,000 minus 54,000 minus 6,000. 48,000. Next, bills discounted 1,95,000 less rebate on bills discounted 49,000. So total 6,39,000. So schedule number 13, interest earned. So under schedule number 13, interest earned, then interest on RBI and others. While you writing the schedule, you should mention number 1, interest, this is 6,39,000. Number 2, interest on RBI, nil. Number 3, others, nil. Bare idru akade eshtu sadhyakke ashtu barpadi aste onde. And other incomes, that is schedule number 14. ಯಾವುದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅದರ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ 14 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಮಿಷನ್ ಬ್ರೋಕರೇಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ 1 ಕಮಿಷನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 2 ರೆಂಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ 3 ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆನ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ 4 ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆನ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 5 ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆನ್ ರಿವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ 6 ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಯಾವುದೆಲ್ಲ ಉಂಟು ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಈ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಯಾವುದಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಒಂದಿದೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಷನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಟು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ಕಮಿಷನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಟು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 8,200 ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅಂಡರ್ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ 14 ಸೊ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ 14 8,200 So this is income. First income 6,39,000 and 8,400. 6,39,000 first income. Interest earned schedule number 13, 6,39,000 and other incomes schedule number 14, 8,200. So total 6,47,200. Next, interest expended. So interest expended, we should see on the interest on deposits. Interest on deposits, term deposits, then savings bank deposits. Second item, interest on fixed deposits, ₹2,40,000. Second, expenditure. Interest expended, schedule number 15. Interest on FD, ₹2,40,000. Next, interest on current accounts, ₹42,000. Interest on current accounts, ₹42,000. Next, interest on SB deposits, ₹68,000. So total interest expended, ₹3,50,000. Relation of the new interest on fixed deposits, savings bank deposits and current deposit, interest expended. And also interest on RBI. If you borrow a loan from RBI or other banks, then you should pay the interest. So interest expended, ₹3,50,000. Next, operating expenses. Operating expenses, schedule number 16. Operating expenses, salaries, rent, printing and stationery, then advertisement, depreciation, director's fees, auditor's fees, then legal fees or legal charge, then postage and telegrams, repairs, insurance and sundry charges. So in this problem, rent and taxes 18,000. Rent and taxes 18,000. Next, directors and auditors fees 4,200. Next, postage and telegrams 1,400. Printing and advertisement 2,900. And sundry charges rupees 1,700. Then establishment 54,000. Establishment means payment to and provision for establishments. Payment to and provision for employees. That is employee salaries 54,000. So total 82,200. So operating expenses 82,200. So the total expenditure 432,200. Third step, profit or loss. Profit or loss. So profit for the current year. Profit for the current year. Income minus expenditure. 6,47,200 minus 4,32,200. Income minus expenditure 3,15,000. And brought forward profit from the previous year. Brought forward profit nil. No. So total profits of the year rupees 3,15,000. Next, fourth, appropriations. So first, to transfer to statutory reserve, how much amount you should transfer? Profit correct or no? 6,47,000 minus 4,32,200. 2 lakhs. 2,15,000 appropriation transferred to statutory reserve, that is 20% of 2,15,000. 2,15,000 into 20%. This was the 43,000 transferred to statutory reserves and other reserve. No. Next, government transfer or dividend, nil, and the balance carried to balance sheet. How much amount? Balance carried to balance sheet. Balance carried to balance sheet. 43,000. Total 2,15,000. So the balance carried to balance sheet 1,72,000. Balance carried to balance sheet 1,72,000. So this is the profit and loss account of a banking company.